In this next lesson, we'll be adding some descriptive operating features, which will give us some variables to use when we get to the section where we're creating a predictive model to predict the duration of the next regenerating cycle for each dryer. We're going to be calculating two descriptive operating features. First, drying cycle barrels, which is the total number of barrels that a dryer sees during each drying state or each drying cycle. So we're going to be looking at the feed rate, which is in units of barrels per day, and converting it to total barrels using a function in acid analytics. So that total will continue until the dryer goes into either standby or regeneration state, and then that total will be zeroed out. The second analytic, lifetime barrels, will be exactly the same as the first, except we're not going to zero it out. So it will continue to accumulate barrels throughout the entire life of the dryer. This could be many months or many years, but the objective of that metric is really to look at the overall use of the dryer over time so that the two dryers' usages can be compared to determine whether we've managed the dryer beds properly to get the most out of them during their life. We're going to be using one acid analytic to calculate both of these quantities. And so we're going to have several steps. The first step will be to retrieve the timestamp of the last archive event for the process flow. And to do that, we're going to be using the prev event function of acid analytics. Then the next step will be to calculate the drying cycle barrels. And in this calculation, the first step will be to check to see if the previous value for the feed flow as well as the current value are not bad. If they are, then we're going to execute the no output function, which basically means nothing happens and we wait till the next time that this analytic gets executed to reevaluate. If they're okay, then the next step will be to check to see if the best operating state, which we calculated in the previous lesson, is in the drying mode. If it's in drying mode, then that means we can go ahead and add to our total. So we'll take the current value of the drying cycle barrels and add the total of the feed flow using the tag total function between the timestamps of the previous value, or sorry, the previous timestamp for the feed and the current time. So we'll incrementally add little bits of flow each time that this analytic gets executed. And then if it isn't in drying state, well, we'll just go ahead and zero it out. That resets the total. So you can see in the trend below, the cyan line that's sort of brightened there shows you what the results of this calculation looks like. Basically, the total ramps during the drying cycle and then gets reset during the regeneration and standby states. And then the final step will be to calculate the lifetime barrels. And it's really exactly the same as the previous step for drying cycle barrels, except we're not going to reset the output. So in other words, if the drying state is not drying, if it's either standby or regeneration, we're going to execute a no output command, which means don't do anything. So you can see the result of this calculation below where, again, the cyan trace increases during the drying state, but then it kind of flattens out. It basically stays horizontal during the regeneration and standby states. But once the dryer goes back into drying state, the accumulation continues, and we get an ever-increasing curve of how many barrels have gone through this dryer for its entire lifetime. Okay, so we'll go ahead and review now what these calculations look like. So we're back in PiSystem Explorer, and we're looking at the library view to look at the dryer template. And currently, we are focused on the dryer state, which we've finished. And for this hands-on exercise, we just want to really review what goes into these totals that we're calculating in the total barrels dried analytic, which is this one right here. So you can see the equations have been put in there for you. These are the ones we discussed in the PowerPoint. Just a couple of features about AF Analytics that I thought I would point out is, first of all, you'll notice we're using the tag total function. And I mentioned that the units conversions are handled for you. So just for a second, let me go over to the attributes tab. And let's take a look at the feed flow, which is this attribute here. Now this is a pie point coming in from the process. And you'll notice that we have specified this attribute to use the barrels per day engineering units. So the units of measure that we provide in Asset Analytics are pretty extensive. You can see a list of them. So basically, all sorts of measurements, all sorts of units. You can even add your own if you want. But I thought I'd make this point because sometimes it's difficult considering the time span you're looking for and the volumetric or the mass flow rates that you're talking about. It's difficult to calculate on the fly all the conversions required to get from a rate to a total. And simply by specifying these units of measure in your AF model, that the functions that Asset Analytics provide take care of the units of conversions for you. So it's very convenient, it's accurate, it's correct. You don't even have to think about it. It just works. So when we look at the calculated attributes that we're doing in our Asset Analytic, we specify the units of barrel, which is the total barrels. Now we could make that thousands of barrels. We could, you know, put anything in there that we want, volume wise, and AF Analytics would do the conversion for us. So going back to the analysis template, in our equations, when we use the tag total on a rate, it's going to do all that for us. So it's very important, and I really want to stress that point. Use the engineering units feature because it's going to make your life a lot better, and you're going to minimize your errors and take care of a lot of extra conversion factors and things in your equations that you don't have to worry about. So that's one thing. Second thing is, there's also this button over to the right that says evaluate, and that's kind of useful too as you're building out your Asset Analytics. So if you're to check the evaluate button, what happens is it's going to go back and look at all the current values of things and provide you the results so you can check your calculation. Now, you'll notice the results we're getting here aren't very exciting, and that's because we focused on dryer A. And currently dryer A is probably in a regeneration phase, and so it doesn't, you know, things have been zeroed out and there's no outputs to summing up the totals. But if we go over here and decide we would rather look at dryer B, for instance, again, remember the link, we can change the context of our template to focus on a different asset. So we'll click dryer B. Now we're looking at dryer B. Let's do the same thing. Now we can see dryer B is in a drying state, and these are the current calculations that we would be getting from this analytic at the current time. So you may decide to put in a step that just basically shows the current value of something or really anything you want. So keep in mind you have that evaluate button as you're building out the Asset Analytics to kind of test things to see how things would look using current values for things. Okay, now what I'd like to do is let's just take a look in PyVision to see what these analyses look like in real time. So going back to PyVision, we'll open the display called Total Barrels Dried to take a look at the results of these two analytics that we just reviewed. And we have a trend, one for each dryer, showing the quantities we just calculated. So if you go ahead and highlight the drying cycle barrels one, you'll see that we have the totals accumulating during the drying cycles, but then getting zeroed out. And then if you click the lifetime barrels, you'll see that we have the ever-increasing trace where we're adding the total, adding to the total during drying states. We don't zero it out. We just keep adding more and more and more barrels to give us an overall lifetime calculation. So this one will go on for several years to always tell us how many barrels of material went through the molecular sieve within a drying bed. Now, we may want to take a look at the entire year to see how well we're managing these two beds as kind of a comparison. So what you can do is select both trends by holding down the control key and then going to the ad hoc trending feature of PyVision. So here we've put the traces together. So now we have everything in one trend, but we just want to focus on the lifetime barrels. So why don't we just uncheck the ones we don't want? So we'll get rid of all of these. Until we just have the two lifetime barrel totals, one for A and one for B. Now, the other thing we can do is let's change the time range. So we already have the end time set to be the end of the year, December 31st. So I'm going to go in here and change the start time to be January 1st. Okay, so now we have a real accurate account of how the barrels have been going through and how we've kind of treated each dryer. And you can sort of see that it's pretty good. There's a period of time there in April and May where things got pretty far apart. And it looks like one of the dryers really took the bulk of the load, which isn't what we want. But then by the end of the year, then things tend to get better. A couple of points here. Number one is that this kind of insight can be easily gained by working with asset analytics and your data. You can see from the examples we've done, this wasn't that hard. We did some backfilling, and now we have a much better confidence level of how we're actually managing these things, where we didn't know that before. The other thing is it kind of built up. We started out by defining the states, so we know when to make the additions, when to totalize, when to not totalize. So things kind of build up on each other. Now, what we're hoping to do is to kind of maintain our good performance here, as we see at the end of the year, by putting together a predictive analytic to help us really make sure we're aware of when we think it's time to do the next regeneration. We're going to use a little simple predictive model to do that, and some of the quantities that we've calculated in asset analytics so far will help us do that. Okay, so we're done with this exercise. Now it's time to move on to the next section where we'll be extracting the data for use and development of our predictive model.